Good evening and welcome to Millennium Stage. Please give a warm welcome to the Red Brothers Quartet.
Thank you. So great to be back here. The Millennium Stage feels kind of like home to us. Robert and I and James King, we play the annual Christmas Day jazz concert, and we have for many years. And how many of you have come to that? Okay. So it's always wonderful, and it's always wonderful to be here any time of year. And before we get started, I'll introduce the band to you. On bass, one of our great friends and colleagues and one of the great bass players anywhere, the great James King at the bass. The young man on drums is, I'm gonna have to just brag a little bit and mention that he was a student of mine. I'm very proud of that because he's so accomplished, and he's one of the rising stars here in Washington on drums. The wonderful Andrew Hare at the drums. And on piano, my favorite piano player, and it's in the contract that I say this, younger brother, Robert Redd. We're gonna open up with a little blues, a happy blues. And this is a tune, it's a little blues tune that I composed earlier this year for a great venue that I play often in Eugene, Oregon. This is for the Shed Institute in Eugene. If you're ever there, do go to an event at the Shed. It's really, really nice. And tonight I'm gonna dedicate this tune that I call Blues in the Shed, dedicated to a great friend who we just lost named Con Sheffer from Eugene. And this is Blues in the Shed. Hope you enjoy it. Thank you. Andrew Hare at the drums. Beautiful. James King once again, bass. Robert Redd. That was a tune by the great jazz composer and band leader Thaddeus Jones. And that's a tune that the Thad Jones Mel Lewis band recorded many years ago. And it's called 3-in-1 by Thad and Mel. And I should mention that Thad and Mel started that big band performing at the Village Vanguard. And the owner of the Vanguard, Lorraine Gordon, just passed away this week. And we wish her to rest in peace. She was certainly a New York legend. All right, so where are we going to go from here? How about if Robert and I do a little duet? Give the other guys a little break, and we'll do a little Red Brothers duet right now. And this is a tune that we always think of Charlie Bird when we play this tune. I had the privilege of playing with Charlie for 19 years. I began playing with him when I was 4. No, I started with him when I was 21, and it was 1980. We'll stop doing math at this point. And then Robert played with him late in Charlie's career. Robert recorded a record with him, a CD with him, which is now probably streaming someplace, and also performed with Charlie quite a bit. So this is dedicated to the memory of Charlie Bird, and this is a great bossa nova composition by Antonio Carlos Jobim, Desafinado.
Thank you.
Thanks so much. And I should also thank the DC Jazz Festival, Willow Jenkins, and Sonny Sumter, the whole gang, for having us. We really appreciate it. It's always a pleasure to be a part of this wonderful event. And thanks to all of you. It's such a wonderful crowd here today. It's great. We're going to continue with a tune called Evidence. This is a tune written by Thelonious Monk. It's based on a standard called Just You, Just Me. And for all of you swing fans, jazz fans who know the tune Just You, Just Me, don't even look for it in this tune. You really won't hear it, but it's in there, trust me. And this is a brand new arrangement of Evidence. Hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. There was another Antonio Carlos Jobim classic called Corcovado, or Quiet Nights. And we're going to wrap the program up right now and play one more tune. And before I do, I'd like to mention the gentleman in the band one more time. At the bass, the wonderful James King at the bass. James King, a DC legend. At the drums, the very talented and musical Andrew Hare. Andrew Hare at the drums. At the piano, the great Robert Redd. And I should mention, if you're anywhere in the globe, on the globe, and you happen to run into the current version of the Duke Ellington Orchestra, which is still active, still playing, and there's a connection right back to Duke Ellington, the original Duke Ellington band. And it's a great band. They just came back from a tour of Asia. They're not the only, you know, they're the other people that went to Asia this month. Anyway, Robert is the pianist in that band, the Duke Ellington band. We're very proud of him. So we're going to wrap it up with a tune that was composed by someone who's not quite as prolific as Duke Ellington or Antonio Carlos Jobim. I wrote this next composition. And this is a tune that I dedicate to my lovely wife, who's sitting right here. And I call this A Groove for Gail. And I should also mention that we have other family here. We have Kelly and Jacob Redd, my niece and nephew, sitting right here in the front row as well, from Tupelo, Mississippi. And my other niece, Katie Redd, and her boyfriend, Atharva, sitting right here. Round of applause for them. So it's really fun to have friends and family listening to you. So this is A Groove for Gail, and thank you all so much. This has really been a ball to play for you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you for joining us at the Millennium Stage. For more information about upcoming Millennium Stage programming, please visit us online at kennedy-center.org or on Facebook. We hope you enjoy the rest of your evening at the Kennedy Center.